Mark, thanks a lot for joining me. Have you had a chance to reflect on what must have been a whirlwind few months for you?
Yeah, it's been good, hasn't it? Obviously, being away in South Africa was a fantastic tour, and to beat their A side when it was virtually their second best side is really pleasing. And off the back of that, I've managed to get myself a test call up, which is I'm over the moon.
Can you talk us through how that all came about? Was it a phone call or a message through to you?
Yeah, it was a text message came through. I was on the plane with Durham on pre-season at Dubai. I landed in Dubai and obviously turned your phone back on, and it was a text message from James Whittaker. So it was a bit of a shock, but I loved it.
Was it a shock in terms of the fact that you haven't made as many first-class appearances as I suppose you might have hoped for due to injuries?
Yeah, I was surprised. Obviously, I haven't played that many games compared to other lads around the country, but hopefully the selectors have seen something in us and I can prepare them on the pitch.
Proud day, I'm sure.
Definitely. I got a little bit emotional on the plane when I spoke to my mum and stuff like that, so I think it's expected, but I'm immensely proud of being called up, but I have to do the business now.
How have the lads been as well here at Durham?
Yeah, obviously they've been really supportive and not taking the mickey out of us at all. So, yeah, and just to make matters worse, I think I took my England Lions cricket bag off to Dubai, and of course then I was picked, which they didn't take the mickey out of us for that either. So, yeah, they've been good with us, to be fair.
You've got to stay true to yourself, haven't you, over the next few months?
Feet on the ground, they keep your feet on the ground. But, yeah, I'll be going there to be myself and hopefully have a laugh with the England lads now.
How do you react to all the attention suddenly thrust upon you, because it's gone from being a fairly quiet season last year to suddenly you're in the limelight all the time at the moment?
Yeah, well, I had to turn my phone off in Dubai one day because it was just going absolutely crazy. I've never had attention like that ever. The wild blokes like, which is not probably the best. I was hoping for a few more women, but it was not like that. So, yeah, I had to turn my phone off and it's been crazy, but I go with it, I guess.
And it's not the first person from Ashington, not the first cricketer from Ashington to make strides into the England team. You must be very proud of that. I've seen you've been back to your hometown quite a bit recently.
Yeah, Harmy's give us a bit of advice. Obviously, it's great for the town and the area where I'm from that we've had two people selected to play for England. Harmy's been a big influence on my career so far and always there to give us advice and make sure I'm doing the right things. And just good to have him around, I guess, but I'm not 6'5", and I'm not. I don't bowl thunderbolts like he does. Well, not as big of a thunderbolt, but I don't know what was in his water. But he's a great lad.
Are you hoping to add a bit of colour to this England team? We've all seen the interviews, recent interviews about horses and things like that.
Well, if I can help, that definitely keep the spirit high in the camp. Yeah, I'll take my horse with us. That's for sure.
And in terms of Durham this season, initially you won't be playing a part, but do you hope for big things here?
Definitely. I think as a squad, I see a lot of talent in this team, and hopefully we can push up for more trophies. I think that's what we've got to look for here at Durham. We've always got to be looking to win things, and if I can contribute along the way, then I hope to do that.
Providing the bowlers stay fit, you've got a seriously talented group of seamers here, haven't you?
Definitely. Obviously, John Hastings is coming across. We've got Onions, Rushworth, myself, Jamie Harrison, Paul Coughlin, Usman Arshad. So there's a long line. Sorry if I've missed anyone out there, lads, but we've got a long line of bowlers there. So hopefully if someone gets injured or if someone's called up like Stokesy or anyone like that, then we've got good enough cover.
Top man, thank you very much.